What's up, bookish babes? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'll be sharing with you guys 10 books to get you out of a reading slumps. Now, if I read any one of these books, I'm 9 times out of 10 gonna dive into something else, because these books are so good that, you know, they just make you want to read. They just make you just feel like you can just read as many books as you want. Like, it makes you feel invincible. But I guess it's just me, but maybe it's just me. But I'm going to share with you guys the 10 books that I have read multiple times back to back, besides Throne of Glass series. You know, just share with you guys. I mean, some of these books ain't going to be a shock to none of y'all, because I'm always talking about these books. I'm always saying, like, you need to read this book. And if you watch my shorts, then you know one of the books. But we're gonna go ahead and dive right into the video and not keep on chatting. Now, the first book is The Love Hypothesis. If you don't know what this book about, it's about a scientist. It's like Elliot Hazelwood. She writes about women in STEM. And I thought I wasn't gonna like this book, but boy, when I read this book, it's like a 5-star book, because it's fake dating. It's just everything. Olive is trying to convince her friend that she's over this guy that she used to date, so that her friends can talk to him, which I thought was weird, because why would you want to talk to somebody your friends to talk to? I thought that was kind of weird, but that didn't take away from the book for me, because I wouldn't do it. But we're not talking about personal life choices. We're talking about the book. She's basically trying to convince her friend that she's over the guy that she used to date, and she's seen her friend coming down the hallway, and she just randomly kisses this guy right here. And when she finally, you know how you just do something without, you know, thinking, and then when you pull back, you actually pay attention to what you did? That's what she did. And she was like, oh damn, I just kissed whatever his name is, Adam. I just kissed Adam, who happens to be a professor, and he's supposed to be like this grumpy professor who's always mean, and you know. But this book was a 5-star read for me. I absolutely enjoyed this book. This book was everything. If you haven't read Love Hypothesis, I don't know what you're doing, because she don't came out with a whole nother book called Love on the Brain, so you need to read this. Now, Love on the Brain, I didn't like that much, but you know, we're not talking about that book. So yeah, I love this book, The Love Hypothesis. The next book I want to recommend to you guys is my all-time favorite. Well, it's one of my all-time favorite books, and it happened one summer. It's by Tessa Bailey, and it's about a girl named Piper, who's a rich girl that likes to party. And one night, her boyfriend broke up with her, and she wanted to have her little last hurrah moment to show him that she wasn't stressing him. And by her doing that, you really know she was stressing him, because like, why, what point are you trying to prove? But anywho, she has her boyfriend broke up with her, and she threw this little party, broke into this building, and her stepfather was like, yo shawty, I don't have enough for you, you're spoiled, you don't do nothing, like, being an influencer, I ain't gonna pay your way in life. But her dad don't know what he's talking about, because being an influencer is a very profit career. But anywho, he just wanted to show her, teach her a lesson. He sent her to this place that her dad, I think, what was the Harvard called? Westport. He sent her to Westport, and she met Brandon, and Brandon was like this little grumpy widow, and he just didn't like Piper, because he felt like she was just coming in and taking over his territory, which it was. He really liked her, because she was cute, and you know how guys are. They just want to be like, you know. But anywho, she end up meeting Brandon, and baby, some part in here got a little bit spice, so please know that it's not a closed door. It's very much open door, and you won't, yeah. Don't read it on a Sunday. The next book is Things We Never Got Over. If you're not tired of hearing me talk about this book, then good, because I'm gonna continue to talk about it. Now, It's Things You Got Over by Lucy Square. One thing about Miss Lucy Square, she know how to jump right into the story. You don't have to sit there and, like, sometimes I just don't care what happened in the past. Like, I don't care. Like, just tell me what's going on now. Like, I want to know what's going on now in the moment, what's happening, who did what, where is what. Now, Tina has a sister named, Naomi has a sister named Tina. And Naomi, being the good sister she is, go rushing to see what's wrong with Tina, because Tina called her and was like, hey, can you come with me and talk? And Naomi go up there and find out that her sister done left her with a child, her child that she didn't even know that she had. Her mom didn't know, her dad didn't know that her sister had a whole child, and the child is superb. Like, I absolutely love Waylay. Now, this is a small town romance, and this book right here got me into small town romances, and small town romance are not my favorite it's my favorite trope now. Small town romance, single parent. I love it because I love kids. I love kids in books. Like, superb. Like, they just write the kids so freaking funny that it's just like, they just say anything that come to their mind. Now, my children don't do that. Please. These children right here do that. Well, this child right here. But Waylay is a sweetheart. She meets Knox because Knox thinks she's Tina. And Knox come in on some big bad bully stuff and was like, you gotta get out of here, and not knowing that she was a whole twin and she wasn't the person he thought it was. But he ended up letting her move into one of his little camp lodge cabins so that she can take care of Waylay and figure herself out. And yes, 5-star. If you haven't read this one, you need to read it, like, now, because things that come into light. She's coming out with another book to this series. I think it's about the brother. Not quite sure. I forgot. But yeah. I'll read this. The next book is The Silent Patient. Now, this book was recommended through TikTok. And I, like, this was really the first book that I read before I started reading. And it was The Silent Patient. This is the very first, like, this book right here was the book that started all this. Like, this right here. This book right here started all this. When I first read this, I was like, girl, what's going on? Like, why did lady kill her husband and shut up? And then it made me start thinking, like, I wonder, do people really do that nowadays? Like, do they kill their significant other and just stop talking? And instead of going to prison, they go to a mental facility? Like, I start thinking that, but, you know, that's just my brain. My brain just automatically go left field at all times. But it's The Silent Patience by Alex. Y'all see his last name. I don't know how I pronounce his last name. I don't want to butcher it. It's like, we'll say Michael this. I don't know. But this book right here is so freaking good. Like, it has a twist to it that you wouldn't even see coming. Well, no, because I was like, when I read it, I was like, wait, what? Now, hold on now. But she ended up killing her husband one day, just like really just killing him. Everybody was like, they were so happy, but you never know what's going on in people's house. So I don't see why people like, oh, they were just so happy. Like, you don't know, sis. Just shut up. Just like, oh, well, dang, this seems like they had an issue with me. As a matter of fact, just don't even say nothing. But she killed her husband, and then she just stopped talking. Like, she never said anything else. Now, the therapist, his name was Theo. Psychopath. But anywho, Theo really need to get checked out. Like, and when I really think back on it, like, he really needs to be the one in the, like, the psych ward. Like, yeah. He was like, well, I can get her. I want to try to get her to talk. And he got hot on the facility trying to get her to speak and tell what happened that night. And yeah, if you haven't read The Silent Patient, read it. It's good. The next book is The Inheritance Game. Now, this book is about Avery. She just randomly inherited billions of dollars from a guy she didn't ever know. Like, she never met in her life. She inherited his whole inheritance. And now she has to go through these riddles and puzzles and maze and, like, jump hoop. Like, she has to do all these things in order to get the money. Like, for the money to go directly into her bank account. Like, her name's to be on it. She has to do all these riddles with the grandsons, Jameson, Grayson, and Alexander. Now, the Hawthorne brothers are superb. I absolutely love Grayson. I love Alexander. No, I love Jameson and I love Alexander. But Grayson was a bit kind of moody to me. Like, he was very much moody at all times of the day. Like, moody. Like, I don't even see how people are team Grayson, but it's not my place to judge. But if you're team Grayson, get help. therapy, please. But yes, Jameson and Alexander are my two favorite out of this book. And if you read this book and enjoy this book, it's two more books behind this. It's the Hawthorne Legacy and the Final Gambit. And she's also coming out one with called a book this year called The Hawthorne Brothers. So yeah, that's The Inherited Game. The next book is The Fine Print. Now, I'm not just gonna say this is the next book. Any book that Lauren Asher writes, I'm reading, because she just have a way of, I don't know, like she just have a way of writing characters. Rowan, now this book is about Rowan. He's a brother of two. His grandfather left a will that's saying like him and his brother have to do different things in order to get their inherit their part of the business of Dreamland. It's kind of like a Disney World inspired book, and it's billionaires. Like, girl, why we gotta discuss why you should read about rich men? It's like, just, this man's rich, read about him. It's good. He meets Zara. Him and Zara kind of bump heads, but he's kind of obsessed with Zara because Zahara did that. But yeah, and yeah, that's all I'm gonna say about this book. If you haven't read it, read it. And if you enjoy this book, it has another book that's following it called Terms and Condition, and a new one that's coming out called Final Offer. So yes, now the next book is by Colleen Hoover, and it's a reminder of him. Now, any book of Colleen Hoover is guaranteed to get you out of a slump, because one thing Miss Hoover know how to do is write a book. And she don't know how to do nothing else in her life. She know how to write a book. And this one happens to be about Kenna. And something happened a while ago. She ended up in prison and lost custody of her daughter. And she get out, basically trying to get her custody back. Or just see her child. She just wanted to see her child. Now, this book had me so triggered, because I was so sad for her. Because, like, she kept explaining, like, she kept explaining herself as to why, like, what happened and what, like, you know, she kept explaining herself to his mom and his dad. Like, I understand you lost a child, but you ain't gonna keep my child away from me. Like, either you gonna let me see my child or you gonna run me my hand. Like, it's as simple as that. No, we're gonna do it the legal way, Kiana. We're gonna go to court about it, because this book right here had me very much triggered. But her, I feel like her, how her and Ledger actually got together was kind of weird and rushed a little bit. Like, it just I don't know, it's just me. But I did enjoy this book, and that's Reminder of Him by Colleen Hoover. So any book by Colleen Hoover is guaranteed to get you out of a slump. The next book is A Good Girl Guides to Murder. Now, this book is about Pip. She's writing a she's doing a senior project, and she's doing it on about this girl and guy that got killed, Andy Bell and Sal single. Yeah, and it was put out in the news that Sal killed Andy, but he killed Andy and turned around and killed himself. But she didn't believe that that's what happened, so she went digging and doing investigating and found out what really happened. This book is so good. I didn't like the third book, because at this point I feel like, why you keep telling me about the same thing? Like, but you know, it's another book, it's two books behind it. Is A Good Girl Guide to Murder, A Good Girl Bad Blood, and As Good as Dead. I didn't like As Good as Dead that much, but those are two I really enjoyed. The next book is a young adult romance, and it is The Do-Over. It's basically about this girl that have to constantly go over Valentine's over and over and over again. So the title of itself, she keeps meeting the same guy over and over. Now, she's in a relationship, but she keeps running into the same guy constantly, back to back to back to back to back. And yeah, it's a quick read, it's cute, it's rom-com, you'll enjoy it. Now, the next and the last and final book is Honey and Spice by Babalu. And it's about a girl named Kiki and this guy named Malachi. Kiki have a radio station for her college to teaching the girls how to basically stand on their own and not take nothing from these guys. And Malachi is the new guy on campus, and he's supposed to be the new playboy. They got all the girls on campus going crazy, and Kiki and Malachi start fake dating. And just for an episode on her show, like fake dating Malachi or something. And Malachi is helping Kiki with the project on her radio in their fake dating, but Kiki is also helping Malachi on a film that he's trying to make. So it's basically fake dating. It's really a good book. I absolutely love this book. I prefer you listen to it, because when she's recording her podcast, like, you actually hear it as in you're listening to a podcast. But those are all the books that I have to offer you guys to get you out of a slump, mention to you guys, however you want to put it. And I hope you guys read this book. If you read them, let me know. If you have any other books that you recommend for getting people out of a reading slump, comment down below in the comment section. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace.